new voices, I'd like to welcome all of you to the Mahaiwe Theater. First, I must thank Mr. Al Schwartz, the owner of the theater, who's been so supportive and so great. Then I'd like to thank you all. I know many of you have traveled many hours to get here today, and I think it's great that you came. And now, I'm very excited to present a very, very special performer and friend, Michael Hedges.
Watermelon man. get it.
A new age fake book. It's actually a sort of a progressive country and western tune. I don't really know what to call it. It's called Watermelon Man, though, and it's the title. It's by a friend of mine, Willis Ramsey. It's really nice to play here. Boy, what a wonderful afternoon and meal and wonderful place to come. Thank you. infatuated with the IBM Selectric correctable typewriter. It was quite a machine back a couple years ago before everybody started using computers. And I wrote this tune that was supposed to be the sounds of a typewriter, but not using a dictaphone with a letter on it. Maybe instead of a dictaphone, maybe a Walkman typing to some pop tune. This is the sound of a typist gone funky. And so I wanted to call it the IBM Selectric 2 correctable, but my lawyer and IBM's corporate lawyers didn't seem to see it eye to eye. So I didn't get to call it that. And rather than get bitter and call it mood music for corporate lawyers, I decided to call it Hot Type. There comes a time in every guitar player's life when he or she has to move on and go on to bigger things. Thank you.
Stay out of the way.
Lily, you see the instrument I just got? I'm just kidding. But I am going to be working some with larger forces than that. For too long, I just started a rock band. So we'll be coming back to the Coliseum next year. This next tune is one that I wrote when I lived in Oklahoma about 10, 12 years ago. And it came about because I guess the main story was that I was working on a term paper first year of my college. Somehow I didn't have to write a term paper in high school. I don't know why. Maybe I got out of it on good behavior or something, or on bad behavior I got out of it. But nevertheless, I was forced with this term paper at the end of the year, and this tune was written right after I started the term paper and decided that since it was due the next day, I would just give up on it. So there's a little bit of frustration in this. A lot of freedom too.
Thank you.
Thank you. What was this great?
I think that was more of the Freedom version.
Thank you.
tell you that one was called Rickover's Dream, and the one before that, the Freedom versus Frustration, is called Silent Anticipations. I'll continue with this tune that was written also in Oklahoma, and it will end the Oklahoma part of the show. With a tune that I wrote early one day. I used to like to go out on the outskirts of the small town where I grew up, Enid, Oklahoma, and just hang out. It's really flat there this time of year. I guess it just seems flatter in the summertime because it's hot. It's really hot and humid there. But in the morning, it's really nice and cool, and there's this particular time of day when you can see the sun and the moon at the same time at different ends of the horizon. And right just before dawn, you can see some stars. And that's what made me write this next music. It's called, it's also the title of my first record. And a new version is on my upcoming album. It's called Breakfast in the Field. This version here is more the version that's going to be on the new record. It's a live album we did over the last 3 months. And it'll be called Live on the Double Planet. I used to have to like fight off people to tune my guitar People used to get in fights at bars I played at, throw up on my monitors. I can't believe there's all these people. Can't see anybody in the balcony. I think there's people up there. I'll direct more of my warblings up there. Susan put on this show. Susan introduced me tonight, and she made all this this auditorium available for me, and brought me up to play, and told me she'd give me some money. So I'd like to dedicate this to Susan Jameson, who I met when she was a waitress at a bar I was playing at, and now she's the promoter, and I'm the vaudevillian.
Don't look back, just see.
Okay, I'm gonna do one more tune, then they've got stuff out there for you to wet your whistle with. I'll go backstage and do the same and come back for another set. I'll do this tune and then we'll do that. Since I got this rock band going to go out in about a year or so, I thought I'd start practicing some rock moves and stuff. Practice some tonight. The first one is
Is everybody feeling good tonight?
You keep trying. Isn't that cool, that red light up there? I'm looking up at it sometimes, you know. Maybe I can make it go off.
I believe in you. Thank you.
Starts out with a medium R&B tempo, slows down into some hard rock, ends in a fit of disco fury. It's called a funky avocado.
I plugged in 9 long years of my life to this family. I got 100 big brothers, sisters on my
manager Hillary Burgess for helping me through these last 3 nights. We're on a short tour. Tomorrow I'm going to take a guitar lesson. And there's this great jazz guitar player named Pat Martino down in Philadelphia. So I'm going to drive down there tomorrow, hang out with him for a day, and then go to a couple guitar clinics. Then I'm going to start work on the next record. So I really appreciate you guys coming back here and coming up here, and I'll try to come back real soon.
Yeah.
I'll leave you with my motto. Let your imagination lead, reality will follow through. This is called Follow Through. Thank you.
Silence and pressure try to turn your story down. Look back, think hard about how that story really sounds. You can be a dreamer. You can be a dreams come true. Just let imagination lead reality.
Especially thanks to all you people who came from New York City tonight.
Yeah!
I think I'll come to your town in a couple months, so I'll play the bottom line again. This guy came to see my show last night in Putney, Vermont. He said he used to bartend at the Bottom Line when I played there, just as a, you know, just had a guest tune there. He said I couldn't even afford to buy a Coke there then. He was telling me it was, they wanted to have me back, so I think I'll be there in sometime early September. Now I can afford to buy a double Stoli. Thank you. Reverberate the walls with a little older music now, and sort of soothe you to drive home, and please drive safely, especially if you're driving a distance. We're not exactly in the middle of a metropolitan area. Watch out for that other guy who had too much to drink. This is about 200 years old, I think. Thank you.
thanks a lot. I really had a good time tonight. I'll try to come back here real soon to Great Barrington. Thanks to all of the Mahaiwe Theater.